Welcome to our studio, and today with us Oliver Seifert. Welcome, Oliver. Hello.
Thank you very much. I'm glad that I could come and visit you and see the picture.
I would like to ask you about how you started to do spearfishing.
First of all, my father, he'd been spearfishing for a long time. He was at the national team at the World Championship in Peru.
He participated in that competition.
Yeah, in a competition in Peru, and he got some problem with his ears, so he stopped when I was born.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I get older, we start to dive again.
So is it part of like lifestyle more than just a sport? It's like part of your life.
Definitely. I live on the water also. When I get some time off, I go to the water always. Sometimes I go for surfing if the weather is too rough to go diving, and if it's totally flat water, we go free diving or spearfishing and do kayak. So I live definitely from the water.
How many competitions have you already participated in?
I've been a lot of Danish championships.
Really?
For like maybe 10 or 5 years, 5, 7 years. But in nationals, I've been in like Norwegian mm-hmm. or the Nordic Championship 2 times and 1 time to the International European African Championship. And so, hopefully going for the next one also.
I know that you can participate as individual or in teamwork. What do you prefer more?
I like the one with the teamwork. Everyone can go and participate and you'll get the points. Maybe you have one bad day, then you're done in the individuals, but mm-hmm. in the team you can still manage to do quite good. Last year I caught 2 Danish records. One of them was the biggest Danish cod. It was 14.28 kilograms, and it was the biggest cod ever caught in Denmark with a spear gun. It was very nice to try, and it was a very challenging diving because it was in the middle of Kattegat, and it's very few days a year you can go to Kattegat to go deep. And we find this big wreck, and we have been there 2 times before, but every time there was so much current that we couldn't dive there, and the visibility is like 4 meters or 5 meters over the bottom. It's like totally muddy, and you can only see maybe mm-hmm. half a meter.
Like in our waters.
Yeah. But here there's a lot of current, and it's at 25 meters or 24 meters, so you have to be careful that you don't get stuck in the fishing nets. And
it's dangerous.
Yeah, it's very dangerous to go wreck diving. But this wreck is so fantastic because you swim down from the top of the sea. You swim and everything is just turning green and get darker and darker, and then suddenly you see the shipwreck start to disappear. And
it's a popular sport in Nordic at home.
In Norway, yeah, it's some people also do it, but they do it like more. They don't do it the same way as Denmark do it. We go looking under the rocks and we really look out for the cods. They're difficult to find in Denmark. You have to be very good at finding big cods in Denmark.
This May is going to be our famous Øresundskarpinne Cup. If you can tell something about this.
Yes, I'm also a bit in the planning. So my father is the main planner of the event, mm-hmm. Together with Oleg and Matti. And this year is going to be hopefully as good as last year. Last year was a bit... it went very well, I think, and it was the first time we held the competition. And in the start, it started off Tuesday night, and the Finnish guys, we have been preparing the boats all day, and we could see, okay, it's very high wind, and the waves are getting bigger and bigger. And the Finnish guys, they were coming at 10 o'clock in mm-hmm. the airport, which is just 600 meters from the harbor. And we know we have to go to this island, and it's like 5 kilometers by open sea, mm. yeah, and in boats. And we were like, okay, now the waves, they're like 1 meter, it's too big. And we go in the night, but everything was okay. We have the lights on the boats and good motors and extra boats if something happened. But we think, okay, this is gonna be pretty hectic. And it did, it did get pretty hectic. But we managed to get out there, and my boat, my engine was going down, only sailing with 1 knot at a, so it was very, very lucky that we go in the harbor. It was totally dark, and it took like 1.5 hours to go there, even though it was only 5 kilometers. The next day, Friday, the weather clears totally up, and we get this perfect water, flat water for 2 days or 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
visibility was around sometime 10 to 20 meters, so it was like the best conditions in Øresund it can get. In the spring it's very good. And there was a lot of cuts. Actually, normally in Øresund, the current runs from the south against the north, so there's this northern current. But this time there has been so much wind from the south, so all of the waters from the Baltic Sea and was blown out in Kattegat, so it has to run back. So it was not normal for the current to go in against the south. That was the southern current, which meant that all of the cuts they have moved around. It's like 80% of the time it's northern current, and now it's 20% of the southern current. So the cuts they were moving, and they weren't at the places where they used to be. So it was quite challenging for everyone. And actually, an Australian guy called Daniel Mann, he managed to win the competition. Everyone can win, and it was a very nice competition, I think.
Are you planning to participate or just help your father to organize this?
No, of course I'll do a lot of helping, but Team Skopina this year again, we will make...
Well, this team that you have, Matti, Alexander and you, are you planning to win the competition?
I don't know if we are going to win. Of course you have to be good at for winning, but you can also be a bit lucky. At this time of year there are big cuts and they are in the shallow waters.
Mm-hmm.
They come up from the deep waters in a sunny day, which was the same as last year. And then they stand on maybe some of the biggest cuts I shot during the scouting or sea was at maybe 4 or 3 meters, which is not normal for a 7 kilo cuts to be in 3 meters of water, but they are at the going to the shallow waters. Mm-hmm. And when the sun is going up and the water temperature is rising, then they come to shallow waters. So everyone can be lucky and get big cuts. If you hit a good area, you can get 5 big cuts pretty easily. But I'm looking very forward and I've done a lot of scouting this time and hopefully we're going to find some good cuts.
Good luck you guys. Yeah. you are ambassador of the Skorpina.
Yeah, so hopefully we will do good. But
maybe you want to tell something on behalf of the organization of the cup and invite people to...
Yeah, of course, everyone is welcome. You have to be quick to buy the tickets because many people will come and we are on a tiny island. So this year we actually also rented a big boat, so we have some extra sleeping places. And of course, last year was a very good event, so hopefully this year will be just as good.
So today with us it was Oliver Siffert. Thank you very much. We're wishing you good luck and do all your best in your future. And good luck.
Yes, thank you very much. I appreciate it.